ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ అండ్ బెస్ట్ విషెస్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. హరి ఓం. శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత సెకండ్ చాప్టర్ వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 18. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ అంతవంతయి మే దేహాః నిత్యస్యోక్తా శరీరిణః అనాశినో ప్రమేయస్య తస్మాద్యుధ్యస్వ భారత. వి హ్యావ్ మెనీ క్వశ్చన్స్. డు వి హ్యావ్ రీబర్త్? After death, where we'll go? Before birth, where we were? Can we predict our life through horoscope? Is there swarga, naraka, etc.? Is there really there is a papa and punya? All these questions, which are not answered by any other university, those questions are answered by Lord Krishna here. But he says, before knowing all these things, first realize about you. He says, before realizing all those things, first you have to realize yourself. Because once you realize the self, your entire perception changes towards the world. Then you will get a kind of new experience with the same body, with the same world. I can say with the same body, in the same world. Because body always threatens us. Because body is decaying. The body, when it decays, whenever I see my body, it is aging. I am worried. People are worried. Therefore, what this body, not only this body, the object which we own, they are also non-eternal objects. They also give us worries. And no object has the capacity to provide what I need, what we need. That is the truth is. We have only one solution, that is what called a Shastra. Shastra will make us worry-free people. But it observes a formula. That formula is very subtle. When Krishna says, please understand about yourself first. How to understand about myself? You have to understand yourself. You have to realize yourself, which is eternal. As a Nitya Vastu, as a Nirvikara Vastu. Nirvikara means that which never goes under any modifications. And also he said, all pervasive, that Vastu which all pervases. He used the word in the last verse, that which is Vyapnoti. Do you remember that which we read in the last words? He said, this sharira, this consciousness, which pervades all over. Yena sarvam idam tatam. Tatam means vyaptam. But we don't understand. And also it confirms that entity which is in the form of me is unlimited, but I am limited. The limitations means it is time-wise and space-wise. Because whatever that object available in this world, they should have a birth date or manufacturing date. The product which is in the form of a fruit of karma phala. I am a product of karma phala. Therefore what? I have a beginning time and there is going to be an ending time. I am means for the body, mind, sense, complex, that which is endowed with as an ahankara. This ahankara which is limited, that limited ahankara must be understood as limited one. That's what Krishna brings here. These dehas, which are limited time wise and space wise, because you know all our body, you see, they are limited. The body begins here and it ends here. It begins here, it ends here. So it is time wise, means space wise limited. It has got birthday and it is going to have a death day, means time wise also limited. That's what Krishna confirms. Not only your body, your mind, emotions, your even the consciousness which is dependent on karma is too limited. You look around all the bodies, means all the shariras, people, all those shariras are anityam. They are antavantaha, endowed with end. But the dehi, the indweller of those shariras, who is expressed, means experienced only by those people, they don't get an end. Now he brings one more point. It means our bodies, they are subject to an end, but I am not. So that I am not subject to an end, that I is, it remains after death. Yes, it remains after death. How? He says, yes, it remains, but you cannot see. So what a big deal in, if a person dies, even I cannot see, that's a normal understanding. You say that a person after death he remains, but if we cannot communicate, we cannot see, what is the big deal in? You don't worry about others. You think about you. You will remain and he will remain. No, it's a kind of satisfying job. Means justifying job. No. See, when you are alive, okay, have you ever seen yourself? No, I am seeing myself. Where? You should not take help of any mirror. You go and stand in front of a mirror, you can see yourself, but that reflection only of your physical system. You cannot even see your emotions. Maybe with or as an expression you can see on the face, otherwise you cannot feel it. When you capture a photo of a person, that physical things are catched. Therefore, when you look at me, you cannot look at me really. When I look at you, I cannot understand your consciousness. That's what he uses the word aprameyaha. Aprameyaha means which cannot be objectified. It means what? Every object is objectified. You can see those objects. These all seen objects are called prameya vastu. Let us understand this word a little bit. In Sanskrit, prama means knowledge. Okay? Knowledge is called prama. And the object which contains the knowledge is called prameyam. Okay? If you have a fruit, pineapple fruit, then when you look at the fruit, that becomes what? You objectify that fruit, therefore that becomes objectified. Therefore it is called object. Then it is called prameya vastu. Every object has got the knowledge. That knowledge is called prama. And there is a connection between knowledge and object. Prama and prameyam are connected. Now, when you look at that object, you are getting the data of that pineapple as a knowledge. through your eyes, eyes becomes what? Instrument. Instrument are called in Sanskrit pramanam, means of knowledge. Means the means of that knowledge of pineapple. Pramanam means means of knowledge. Prama means knowledge. Prameya means object. And receiver of that knowledge is known as pramata. Pramata, receiver of knowledge. Prama, knowledge. Pramanam means of knowledge. And prameyam, the object of the knowledge. This four word. We can make a sentence. Pramata, pramanena, prama, prameyasya, prama, prapnoti. Pramata, the knower of, knower or seer, receives the knowledge of an object through pramanam, through sense object. So that which is not seen or objectified, since object, cannot be called prameyam. Those object which are not objectified, which cannot be objectified, are called aprameyam. Now you cannot objectified even by you. Wherever Krishna comes, you cannot objectify. Now I objectify myself, how you objectify? Like other object? When you use a sense, the sense are valid pramanas. So that means of knowledge are not utilized to realize about you, means you become aprameya vastu. I need not to complicate you. Simply I said, you cannot see you. And you cannot see others. Then what we see? We see their system. Physical and psychological system, that's all. Can we feel them? Need not to be. You feel yourself, they feel themselves, that is enough. But they feel, or you feel yourself as the self means subject. The subject never become object. Subject is to be understood as the subject. You should understand yourself as in the form of I. This I never becomes you, he, she, or it. Never. It means it has got only one person, first person. That's all. That too singular, not plural. And this knowledge, it, you know, you should have the courage to say it. Krishna does it. He smashes. You never see. You know, you have not seen you, you are not going to see yourself as an object. It is not possible because you are a prameya vastu. That's a big wonder. Ah, I cannot be seen by anybody. Yes, you cannot see by yourself itself. Because I need not to see myself through my eyes. Eyes are invalid. Therefore, when people are alive, at that time itself you are not seeing them, you are seeing their karma phala in the form of your karma phala. Okay, what this will provide me? I mean, this knowledge, will it provide any benefit to me? Any knowledge is provided by Krishna, it has got its own glory. I am asking a question. Do you have knowledge about you as you are a human? Yes, sir, I am a human. Okay. When did you get this knowledge? Oh, when I was taught at that time itself. And purpose of knowledge what? To distinguish yourself with from other creatures, isn't it? Yes, yes, sir. But are you utilizing every day that I am a human being? I am a human being. No. Need not to. Once you realize, that helps you to settle in your path, in your way of lifestyle. Isn't it? In that way, here also, all the points which Krishna gives, it will definitely work in your life. You are an aprameya vastu. I am an aprameya vastu. I cannot see myself. This Atma cannot be seen as the worldly object. That is the knowledge one should have. Then what? You need not to attempt it by doing meditation. I want to see Atma, what it is. Atma, is it blue, yellow or red color? Atma is beyond everything. But beyond everything means you should not go, that doesn't exist. It exists in the form of I. You are that. Catch hold of it. That is very important. And Krishna says, Tasmad Yudhyasva. Therefore you go and fight. Now people may get misunderstanding of it. Atma cannot be seen. Okay. Atma is not visible. Atma is Nitya. Atma is eternal. Therefore what? You can kill somebody and you can say that Atma is eternal. Therefore what? I kill. It's not like that. This knowledge should not be misled, misunderstood. Therefore, you have to be careful when you study about this. You should have studied first chapter. There the dharma concept and karma concept, we have to be thorough with that. It becomes a supreme knowledge which is supported by back by so many other steps of knowledge. Now you used to realize about yourself, you are a subject who remain as the subject. You never become object. You need not to become object. That is the point here. You are an avinashi, indestructible entity. That's what the understanding which we should have. And the people around of you, you can take Arjuna, and Arjuna with the people around him, and you, the people around you. You can understand in this way, all the shariras, they are subjected for death, but those indwellers are not. This is one understanding. Then he continues in the next words. Let us read it.
Yayenam veti hantaram yaschainam manyate hatam ubhautau na vijanitaha na yam hanti na anyate.
Now, this Krishna, he says one step further with karma. Because we are endowed with karma. This body, mind, sense, complex, everything is endowed with karma. This ahankara which is endowed with doership and enjoyership. This atma which even doesn't endowed with doership, endowership, enjoyership. But when you mistake, I am this body, you misunderstand yourself, you replace yourself as anatma, as ahankara, you think you are the doer, you are the enjoyer. This literally means what? Ya enam hantaram veti, one who realizes this atma is a killer. And one who realizes this Atma is also killed, because Arjuna, when he kills those people, he will think what? I am the killer. That's what he said. If I kill them, I will get Papa. That's what he said. All those people are Atatayis. If I kill them, I will be caught by a huge Papa. Ahobata mahat papam kartum yavasita vayam. Didn't he tell that? Therefore he says, you are thinking you are the doer. And you also think they can be killed by you. It means what? Atma can be killed. Atma never becomes subject for karma and karma phala. That's the theory here. You have to realize it. Ubhau tau na vijanitaha na ayam hanti na hanyate. So that person who is ignorant to this knowledge alone thinks as a killer, Atma is a killer, Atma is killed also. But Atma is beyond everything. Why? Because he continues in the next words.
Najayate mriyate va kadachit nayam bhutva bhavita va na bhuyaha ajo nitya shashvatoyam puranaha na hanyate hanyamane sharire.
When you realize Atma, you have to realize thoroughly that Atma is never born. Na jayate. Therefore, it never dies. Na mriyate. Okay? So, it is never born, never died. Sometime it gets into manifestation and sometimes it goes away. Is it so? No.
I am na bhutva na bhavita na bhuyaha.
It never becomes into manifestation. It never goes into unmanifestation. This Atma is known as Ajaha, Nityaha, Shashvataha. Ajaha means this Atma is said as unborn. Because this body is born, Asti, Jayate, Vardhate, Vaparanamate, Apakshiyate, Vanashiti, we saw in the last classes. This body is undergoing six kinds of modifications, but not the soul. You are not undergoing because you are unborn. Nityaha means eternal entity. Shashvataha means that which lives forever. I am Puranaha. Purana means ever new. Na hanyate hanyamane sharire. By killing this body, it cannot be killed. It means what? You don't lose yourself even when the death happens. That's what the understanding which we should have. But it said to Arjuna because the context was like that. But here, you should take for you, death cannot separate me from me. Okay? And it happens to kill somebody. We cannot kill those people's Atma. It doesn't mean that you can kill. No, it should not be misled. You should be very careful. Because this Atma Jnanam should be governed by Dharma Jnanam. First you should know Dharma, Dharma Vivekaha. Then alone you can have Nitya Nitya Vivekaha. Atma Vivekaha. Vivekaha means knowledge. Okay. Then he continues.
Veda vinashinam nityam yaye namajam avyayam katham sapurusha partha kam ghatayati hantikam.
These two verses, verse number 20 and 21. Now this knowledge that I am beyond everything, then where the karma comes into the scene? Because this body is nothing but the fruit of karma. This Atma never endows with karma. It is said as akarma in the fourth chapter. This Atma is akarma. But these all other anatmas are endowed with karma. That's what he brings. This avinashinam nityam avyayam enam. This Atma if it is realized as avyayam, ajam, nityam, avinashi, then the person who will say or who won't say that I am killing, they are killed, he will be keeping quiet. He will follow dharma. That is the benefit of understanding. He won't judge anybody. These two verses, you know, they are explained in the fourth chapter well. Because this Atmajnanam should not mislead. It has to be very carefully understood. This is beyond karma. You should not misidentify yourself with ahankara, which is endowed with karma. So when you misidentify yourself, then you will say that I did that, I achieved that, I killed the somebody. Killing somebody means the word should not be mistaken. It's meant for Arjuna's duty. Therefore, you cannot say that I achieved that, I did that, I defeated those people. Saying that, it shows that you are identifying you with limited I. That's what Krishna wants to indicate. It means what? You will suffer by karma phala again. This knowledge will help you to separate yourself from karma phala. It's a highly confidential secret, and to be understood with the proper and appropriate manner. That we will see in the forthcoming sessions. We will deal with karma, and Krishna never leaves with half understanding. We will continue in the forthcoming sessions tomorrow. Hari Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.